Sabbath. The next commandment is, what do we need to get the kids in here for? Because this is what I tell my kids. If somebody read that fifth commandment, it's in our
That your days will be long.
That your days will be long.
Away from the Lord.
What
your life will be. But what I ask, is this a solid rule, or is this a just a principle? The rule. So that seems, I don't know that.
The rule is to honor your parents. Mm-hmm. But it's a principle as far as the longevity of a person's life does it. Huh? Like you bring up, you know, that it might be, you might do that and a bolt will fall on you or something. We're 40 years old. Oh, yeah.
That's a good point right there. It is definitely some there. I'm sure that in past, in the history of the world, there has been somebody that has been the best son or daughter ever and honored their father and mother the best they possibly could, but their life has been shortened by some circumstance. Yeah, or an accident or anything could have taken place.
It's all tied into God's knowledge of what your life is going to be. The days are numbered like hairs on your head. So whether you honor your parents or not, your days are numbered, period. But this is more of, like I said, a rule that I think that this could be physically shortened. That if you did not obey your parents, I think that is.
And I would agree with both of y'all, because it's definitely a commandment to honor your father and mother. And to honor them, that includes all types of things. And honoring your parents has got to do with the age that you are in life, because a child honors their parents in a different way than an adult honors their parents. Because Jacob and Lucas honor me in a different way than Kevin honors Ruth. Because, you know, Kevin's a grown man. And I'm sure Ruth still, if she got a baby, she'd turn him over her knee and slap that butt. You know, he's a pretty big boy right now.
You hear the comment on that?
I'm over the chair.
Just please sit and we'll move right along. But now, so honoring our parents has a lot to do with the age we are. Now, when the person honoring their parents is young, like Jacob and Lucas, for instance, even when they were babies, now, they didn't just automatically know how to honor me. I had to teach them what honor is and how they're supposed to treat their parents. And so another point I want to make is this. Now, we know that the Bible says in some degree how you treat your parents is how long you're going to live. And it's pretty important, and it's a commandment. Now, but think about this. If I don't teach my children how to honor me, what's going to happen then? Then their days may be short, but whose fault is it going to be? It's going to be my fault. Because I didn't teach my children the correct way to honor me. And ignorance is no solution. It's no defense in law or before God, not knowing. And so that's why it's so important that we train up our kids in the way that the Bible tells us. Now, has Charlie Ryan ever fallen short of that? Heck no. Christy has. Yeah, she gonna, somebody will jump or she's strangling the game. So, I know, she's gonna hit me. I'll just put myself in trouble all the time. So, it's a two-way street. And the parent has really a lot to do with this commandment. Because now, let's take it a step further. Just say, and look at the world today. There's a lot of kids that have not been taught how to honor their fathers and mothers. And when they grow up, what happens to these kids? Again, it's not a law or set in stone, but 9 times out of 10, a child that doesn't honor his father or mother is going to wind up in jail, in prison, dead, out on the street, drug addicted. again, the ball's in the parents' court to a big degree in teaching their kids how to honor. And we talked about it a couple Wednesdays ago, how that judgment to the second and third generation, but mercy to the thousands, and it's a cycle. If I don't teach Jacob and Lucas how to honor me, then they're going to grow up and they're not going to know how to honor me. So what's going to happen to their kids? They're not going to know how to teach their kids about honor. So you got another generation that's going to grow up not honored. And that is what the world is right now. Parents have not taught their children how to honor them. And if you cannot honor your parents, you certainly cannot honor God. And it is a sad situation. Satan is attacking our country in this way. This commandment, it doesn't seem like much. And as I was praying and studying about it tonight, I didn't know I would be saying this right now. Because I said, well, we'll get over this one pretty quick. It's just honor your father and mother. That's all it is to it. But the more I prayed about it, the more God started revealing to me just how important this one commandment that gets skipped over a lot. Because this is not one like, I mean, compared to no other gods before me, that's a big, huge commandment. Or no graven images, that's a big one. But this one is just a simple, be good to your parents. That's all it is. But if you really think about it, this is one of the most important commandments that there is. Because a failure to obey this commandment is one reason our country is in the shape it's in. Satan has gained so much ground in our country and in our world by attacking the family structure. Because God had a plan in mind. He said, I want my people to be made up of families. Because we, you know, when we accept Jesus Christ, we get incorporated into the family of God. And so God is a family God. It's all about a family. He said, I want to be one man and one woman, and I want them two to be together forever. Through thick and thin, whatever, stay together. Now, that doesn't always work because we live in a fallen world. But that's the goal, is to stay together and raise a family. So I imagine Satan was sitting back and said, God sure does think a lot about this family thing, don't he? He sure does like families. That just blesses God's heart to see one man and one woman together raising children that honor their parents and honor God. What can I do to mess that up? I'll tell them, instead of one man and one woman, they ought to get men and men together, and women together. And I'll start this thing called government. And I'll get them to thinking that they don't even need a daddy, and the more babies they have, the more money they can make. And, you know, it's just wreaking havoc across our country. The family structure is being destroyed. So how can we combat the enemy right now? Number five, train up children to honor their parents. And not only our own children, but as a church, we need to have the children of this church to honor their own parents, but to honor adults in general, and to understand the importance of that. And I think we fall short on that a whole lot of times. Hey, I'm the one guilty right here. But if we raise up our children in our church to honor their parents, then ain't much we can do about, you know, we can teach them that it's right. We can't make them honor their parents. Y'all, Linda can't make Jacob honor them. There just ain't no way she can do that. But Linda, if she has a chance to speak life into Jacob, she can tell him how important it is to honor me, even